The thrill from Brazil, world ranked number 6 at only 22 years old, Hugo Calderano, a man of many skills making the game exciting at a global level. Hugo Calderano shattering all records from the Americas. He's 2 times Pan Am Games champion, and he's beaten some of the most unbeaten players on the planet in the last 12 months.
Table tennis for me is like a mental war when you're playing against the opponent. You're very close to him, so you always have to know when to do what, when to make some changes. The small difference in material makes a huge difference on the outcomes.
You need to be very fast, very good physically, but also very strong mentally.
Maybe a little bit stronger than in team sports, because if you win, you're alone. If you lose, you're alone. So maybe the feelings are even stronger.
I'm Hugo Calderano, professional athlete. I'm still very young, I'm 22 years old. My driving force has to be the wish to win and the wish to get medals and to succeed. Because of table tennis, I had many opportunities to travel, to see many, many kinds of things, and I'm just beginning my career. I'll see even much more, but the experiences I have are some of the most important things in my life. Is my home. I was born there. I lived there until I was 14. Every time I go back there, I enjoy it so much. I enjoy the weather, to be with my family and friends. Yeah, every time my father has time. Of course, he also has to work. But I always ask if he wants to join me to go out and play some sports. Do some fun activities, to go to the beach, and I think I can get a lot of energy from just being 1 week or 10 days back in Rio.
Can you imagine practicing here in the summer?
Oof.
Now it's fall time.
Wow.
Well, I practiced in Rio from 8 to 14. I was practicing just 3 times a week. And not even practicing, I was like playing matches with the guys here. Sometimes I would come to the club and there were 20 people wanting to play. So I have to play a match and go sit down for another 30 minutes, 1 hour, and wait for my turn. Sometimes even the winner couldn't stay on the table because there were just too many people waiting. So both of them or both of us had to go out. Kind of puts your motivation a little bit down because you really can't do much about of your table tennis to improve. So yeah, it was many years just playing like this, playing matches and coming here. And once I was 13, I was already the best player in Rio.
Things didn't really happen from day to night to us. We've been living this for many years, so originally, I think when he was very young, when he was a kid, we knew that he was very good at sports. We didn't really know which sport he was going to pursue, but we knew he was definitely going to play sports and maybe be a professional athlete. I really don't know when we started to see that this was going to happen. But I think at a certain point, we just started to believe that he could do anything he wanted to. When somebody finally told us he is really good and he can potentially be a very, very good table tennis player, and then we thought it would be okay to let him leave Rio. At the time, it was basically impossible for him to continue developing if he stayed here. He was around 13,
When I decided to follow my table tennis career and to become a professional athlete, I had to move to São Caetano, which was the national training center in Brazil. I started to practice more there. I was practicing 2-3 hours in the morning and the same in the afternoon. I was going to school at night, so my day was pretty full, and I was coming back from school at almost midnight, and my grandfather would wait for me at the window to see when I was arriving, and I was really always really tired, and I just had time to go to sleep and start again next day at 8 o'clock, the same routine every day.
It was very tiring for him. You can imagine a 14-year-old kid with this kind of responsibility, and he would travel a lot to competitions, and then he would stay sometimes 2 months, 3 months away from school. Then when he came back, we would pay for tutors to help him catch up with the subjects.
Actually, when I was 16, I moved to Paris during school, also to practice table tennis. I personally think education is very important, especially when you are very young. It builds your character and your personality. Of course, sometimes you need to do sacrifices. Be so far from my family and from my country. And there were days that I would just cry at night, I think because I wasn't sure and I was alone. It helped me grow and become stronger as every experience like this. I was 18 when I moved to Ochsenhausen. I had some training camps year before. 1 year before, I came 2 or 3 times, and my coach, Jean René, he's working really closely to the head coach of Ochsenhausen, Michel Blondel, which is also my trainer, my coach here. He was already in Ochsenhausen. Everything happened naturally. They saw me practicing. They had the idea of bringing me to practice and to play for Ochsenhausen. So everything happened really fast. And I was just happy to have this opportunity to move to Germany and focus on my table tennis.
I think I met him first time was in 2010, during one tournament in Brazil. He was already, let's say, a hope for the country. He had already a quite big potential at this time.
It helps you become stronger mentally if you live in Ochsenhausen. I don't think if I lived in Rio, for example, I'd be as strong mentally as I am today, just because of the atmosphere in the city. It's much more relaxed. You can see the beaches, the view is really nice. And in Ochsenhausen, if you're here, you know why you're here. You have a very strong goal, and it makes you tough, you know. Of course, sometimes I thought about what my life could be if I didn't do it, but I never had a doubt that this was the thing I really wanted and what I had to do.
Really ambitious guy, and he wants to push his limits and to try to discover what he is able to achieve, I mean, generally. it's a strong choice to come from Rio de Janeiro to Oxenhausen, but I am even more impressed about more than the choice is about how he's acting daily. I think it's really pleasant to see one young guy like this coming from Rio, living in Oxenhausen, arriving to the hall at 8 a.m. morning with big smile, and he's able to enjoy each moment. He knows he has privilege in his life, and this is really nice to see this. There is really interesting contrast between how he is quiet and calm and his determination. And if we transfer this about the game, he is calm and aggressive. And I think this mix is really interesting. Very often, I think in Europe or maybe outside Asia, you can find athletes or players, when they are really aggressive, they can be too exciting or too stressed or too aggressive in a bad way. And I think he has in his personality this really good balance. And we all often say with my friend Michel Blondel, we try to manage and to give direction to him. He's more than a table tennis player. He's like a sportsman. You ask me what he can be in the future. I think he can be really a good ambassador for our sport because his dimension can be bigger than only table tennis.
And welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the Men's World Cup, the ITTF 2018 Liebherr Men's World Cup. This is the first day of action, and it will be quite exciting. So, Hugo Calderano, one of the top players that people are watching around the world right now wondering, can he take the Men's World Cup? The answer is absolutely. He's shown us before that he can beat the best in the world, and there's no one that is out of his range. And Hugo Calderano takes game number two to tie it up at one game apiece. A dominant performance so far. His job is almost done. Calderano is a very aggressive player, but right now he could be getting a bit cautious. He's close to the finish line, just has to take that step. Tough times right now, score tightening up a bit. Calderano loosening up his chokehold now on Lebesson. He was leading the entire match. This is not over yet. Calderano, can he do it? The time is now, and this is the test. And Lebesson takes it. Calderano must be heartbroken right now. Oh, this is going to be a tough night for Hugo Calderano. Really, the great hope for the world.
Yeah, I couldn't play my best level here. I just couldn't adapt to the match, and unfortunately, I lost. Everybody went through hard periods of time that you don't have such a high confidence, and you don't know if you're capable of doing things. But usually I like to focus on the present and on what I have to do to get better and to improve every day, and not think about the consequences of what if I lose, what if it doesn't work out. My goal is really strong, and I really want to get there as much as anyone in the world to be the Olympic champion. But it's also very important to enjoy the process of getting there.
Every time, I think this is something we joke about this until today, even after he had moved to San Caetano and after he had moved to Germany, every time he came back home, I kept asking him, are you sure you want to continue? Are you sure you don't want to stay and give everything up? Because it's like he, I wanted to make sure that he knew that for us, whatever he decided, it would be okay. And then he, it was like he was always reaffirming his commitment and his passion, and that that was really what he wanted to do. So every time he came, and then I asked, do you want to stay? Do you want to give everything up? No, bye-bye, I'm going. And then it was it. And then for us, it was okay. So he doesn't feel sorry. I don't think he has ever felt sorry for himself. It's a sacrifice, yes, but so many people in the world have hard lives. So if you are so lucky to be able to live doing something you love and be healthy and make money out of it, so there's really nothing to complain about. And this is something that the whole family, it's an idea that the whole family shares. My husband always told him from very early, your opponent as a person is more important than the game. So this is something that he has in mind. Of course, the family values, I think, had some impact. But I think mainly it's confidence that comes from within, and he has it. Of course, being good at what you do helps boost your confidence, and then it's a cycle, right?
Many times people ask me, how do you teach him table tennis? But I have to say, if I am honest, probably he's teaching me more than I am teaching him. My mission is to guide him. I think Hugo is successful, and I hope he will not stop here. He will have next steps, because there is a big concurrence, and let's see what will happen. Something I am very proud about what he's doing, and he, of course he can be proud about this, is he's always following his own way. This is true about his own life, but this is also true about his game. I mean, it's not so often when we go out from one defeat, when we are really frustrated, because he can lose because the opponent player is better, or he can lose because he didn't succeed to impose his own game. But every time he will make a choice, and he will go 200% in this choice. And I think this is really one important concept to succeed in high level. I mean, you need to have a strategy and to follow this strategy to make your dream becoming a reality. And finally, the most important is not the final result, but the way that you are taking. If you like and if you love this way, I have the feeling that you can have a really nice life. And this is what we have today, and that's why I hope this will continue for a long time.
Here on the receive from Fang Zhendong over the table. His Chiquita is very strong, his backhand receive. 7-3 serves with Fang Zhendong. Sky lob, rackets twiddled, backhand counter. Two, oh, and he misses the short side. Fang Zhendong takes the points. That being said, tough to return. Fighting so hard, keeping it in play from deep in the backcourt. Time out on Fang Zhendong's side.
Yeah. a primeira sequência foi muito bom.
Right into the body again. These reactions we're getting. 6-6. And the float serve gets a long push off the table. Calderano 1 point ahead. Just blowing off that cool ball toss hand. Second serve. Match point for Hugo Calderano. The thrill from Brazil does it. Hugo Calderano takes down world number one. Latin America, the Americas, and the rest of the world. What a performance. World rank number 6. Hugo Calderano has beaten the most unbeaten player on the planet. The most dominant player of 2018.
Yeah, I mean, I've had, of course, some very tough moments, but it's very important to keep cool, to know the process is long, to have a global view, to have a big confidence on what you have to do and what you're doing daily. But of course it can be shaky sometimes, even if it's not now, even if it's not in 1 year, 2 years, you get where you want.
I'm Hugo Calderano, and this is my story.
Hello and welcome to Day 8, the evening session of our continuing coverage of the 53rd edition of the Quaros 2015 World Table Tennis Championships from Suzhou, Southeast China, located at the Suzhou International Expo Center. Only one match to go on one table in front of 5,500 spectators and broadcasting out to almost 170 countries. The blue ribbon event, the men's singles final. Who will be standing on the podium tonight at the end of this one? Ma Long, the top seed in the blue tracksuit on the left there, the 26-year-old, 5'9". It's a title he's never won before. The men's singles final has always been contested by two Chinese players when it's been hosted in China. He's up against tonight Fang Bo, the 13th seed, and slayer of Zhu Xin and Zhang Zhike as well in the semi-finals. And what table tennis they've both produced. Alongside me tonight, Don Parker. I'm Paul Hand, and we'll be ushering you through this blue ribbon event.
Not quite the final that everybody thought. Yes, we all thought Ma Long would make it, but Fang Bo, something of a surprise element. Of course, he beat Zhang Zhike in the semi-final. I think that was the clash we all thought would be the final. The world and Olympic champion up against the number one player in the world. And here he is in all black. Ma Long, unbeaten this year. He's won two of the World Tour competitions.
Table tennis proving an incredibly popular sport, sparking global interest on social media sites, have been buzzing all around here. The World Table Tennis Championships 2015 achieved 7.7 million Facebook impressions and 823 million hits on the ITTF.com website. So enjoy the best table tennis in the world from China right now on ITTF.com/ITTV.com. There we are then, confirmation of who we're watching. Top seed Ma Long and the 13th seed Fang Bo. What performances they produced in the semi-final matches. Fang Bo crushed Zhang Zhike, the third seed, remarkably, and twice world champion, quite comfortably, 4-1. But both men really hit the ground running when they came out. Can they excel again from the off? Who's it going to be? It's going to take the lead. Fang Bo, winner of the World Junior Championships in 2009. Indeed, Don, we were sharing thoughts earlier. He actually produced the clean sweep in the World Junior Championships, the man at the top of your picture, taking the singles, doubles, and mixed. Ma Long, well, he hasn't had so much luck. He was the World Cup winner in 2012. Semi-finals of the World Championships is as far as he's been in any World Championships, and he's posted those results in 2009, 2011, and 13 in Paris, the last occasion, because, of course, it's held in biannual years. He's been unbeaten this year, as you said, Don. But it's going to be incredible just to see how this one unfolds. So it is today when Ma Long announces his arrival as a legend on the world stage. This is the title that he really wants to silence his critics. He's had a lot of stick for not really being able to produce under the utmost pressure. Zhang Zhike, of course, was the Olympic champion 2012 and twice world champion. Ma Long doesn't have any of that in his trophy cabinet yet. Tonight's a big opportunity for him, Don.
Absolutely. Mr. Lo from Hong Kong sitting in the umpire's chair. He's in charge of proceedings. Massive honour for Mr. Lo. This is, as you say, Paul, the Blue Ribbon event, the final of the men's singles, the St. Bride's vase going to the winner. And Ma Long, I do feel here, for me, is the favourite. They've not played each other in the last 5 years in a major competition. I'm sure they have in the practice hall many, many times, but not in a major competition. I just think Ma Long will be too strong here. For sure, Ma Long was worried about Zhang Zhike. Zhang Zhike has the reputation of producing it on the big stage. Olympic title, two world titles, just appears to be unbeatable when it comes to the big one. And that would have been a really interesting battle. I think Ma Long here psychologically will believe he's got a good chance, as opposed to having perhaps a little bit too much respect, as I feel he would have done for Zhang Zhike.
Format, the best of seven games. First to 11, of course, wins the game. 2 minute warm up, 1 minute timeout per match these players are allowed. And of course, they can towel down every 6 points in multiples when they want to. So it's going to be Fang Bo at the top of your picture to get us underway in this men's singles final.
Interesting that we have no coaches in action here. China, of course. Coaches keep out of it.
Oh, what a start from Ma Long.
He's so quick, takes the counter, top spin on, whips it out wide to the Fang Bo forehand. That's a good topspin down the line by Fang Bo, but what a reaction. Electric on his feet. This is just how he started this morning in the semi-final. That's a great flick from Fang. Top of the bounce, hitting through the ball, this time into the body of Ma Long. Honours shared after the first two serves from Fang Bo.
Well, it seems they're both starting the way they did in the semi-finals, Don, which should make for real fireworks out here.
Ma Long just went for slightly too acute an angle there. Just went off the side of the table.
Oh, fabulous redirection from Ma Long.
Just down the line is such a difficult line to play on at that speed. Just look, that's in slow motion, believe it or not. It looks at normal speed to me, but that was just a tremendous shot. Takes the ball early, elbow wrist, and of course, going down the line, it's a smaller target to aim for. Very difficult shot, particularly at that speed, so 2 points each. What a good serve there from the 23-year-old Fang Bo. He had a clean sweep, as you mentioned, Paul, as a junior. He did it all. Can he now do it as a senior? He is, of course, the surprise package, really, because Yan An, who is one of the top Chinese players, ranked number 11 in the world, some three places above Fang Bo, yet Fang Bo got the nod. Yan An didn't play in the singles, just played in doubles.
So the Chinese coach is not going on the ITTF world ranking list, giving Fang Bo the chance. And my goodness, has he taken it? He's beaten the number three in the world, he's beaten the number two in the world, and he's now up against the number one in the world. What a victory if he could pull it off. And indeed, he's got a 5-2 lead in this first game.
That is a fantastic return, a serve.
If you look at the wrist there, if we get a chance to see it on an action replay at some time, this backhand return when they come across to the forehand side, the wrist bends backwards and comes through the ball. Side spin, top spin, vicious spins.
Fang Bo really opening the shoulders then and uncoiling all that torqued energy from the core and the legs. Still has a lead here of 6-3 with one serve to come. Ma Long tames him with that forehand. Such control as well as pace.
Interesting how Ma Long pins him down the backhand. You see there on the replay. I'm sure Ma Long would have been just about to whip one out wide to the forehand. But looking as though he's happy to force Fang Bo to play backhands from the backhand side. You have to be clever to do that, because players can get very good at running round. This time the forehand down the line into the forehand of Fang Bo.
It's the signature forehand from Ma Long that we've come accustomed to, particularly in this World Championships. He's been dominant throughout.
Ma Long now with the second serve in this sequence of two. I'm sure he'll be looking to get in with the topspin behind the serve. But that was good tactics from Fang Bo. He knows he's got to take a chance on the return. If he plays safe, then Ma Long gets it with the topspin. He went there for the wristy backhand flick, just caught the top of the net. It's exactly what he has to do, be positive on the return of serve. So, 6 points each. Fang Bo, two serves to come.
Knocking his opponent off balance with another thunderous forehand. Getting his weight right down through the ball, Ma Long there. So, four in a row for the top seed. Is this where he stamps his authority on this first game?
The reverse action serve from Fang Bo. Backhand to backhand following. Ma Long comes out on top, so that's quite a run of points now.
For me, he has a lot of intensity and energy from the off. Indeed, they both do. Credit to them both in that regard. Zhang Zhikir for me in the semi-finals, just a little bit flat from the start. Never really ignited. Again, a bullying forehand gets it done.
And again, the tactics. Fang Bo having to play backhands from the backhand side. It just caught the top of the net. That's all I was going to say, Paul. Slightly fortunate, but it was the tactics that were very good from Ma Long there. Very positive forehand topspins.
He extends his run to 7 points in a row, and that brings up 4 game points for the top seed in this men's singles final of the World Championships from Suzhou, China.
That forehand topspin down the line just caught the top of the net. Placement was good. But still, 3 game points remain for Ma Long.
Ma Long then seizes the first game, 11 points to 7. Stay with us here, don't go anywhere. Back after the break. Masterful display from the man in the top of your picture, Ma Long in black, the top seed, off to a flyer. Not only did he hit the ground running, he hit the ground sprinting. 11-7, first game in Ma Long's favour. Start of game two.
Oh, what a backhand return down the line from Fang. The thing that impressed me with Ma Long there, I think he was 6-3 down, Paul, in that game. But he held it together. He played some really outstanding, strong topspin, spraying it around the table.
And for me, he just seems really hungry. There's, you know, he's roaring almost every point, as he was against Zhang Zhike, Fang Zhendong, I should say. But really focused now, Ma Long, very much into this. Intimidating body language too. This is what the crowd want. They want both players bringing their A game simultaneously. We love these kind of rallies.
Interesting how he's keeping it there, as you see on the replay, into the backhand. Both of them very cautious about letting their opponent get in with strong topspins.
Oh, didn't he bite back hard there, the man in black? Just when you thought the youngster had the upper hand.
But the youngster there was clever. He played that forehand topspin with less speed, brushed up the back of the ball, went for a little bit more spin. Clever variation, the variation winning the point. So 2-point lead, Fang Bo starting well, as he did in the first game. He has to keep it going. Again, the tactics were good, backhand topspin down the line, worth a try, just caught the top of the net, flicked it off the end of the table. You get nothing at this level by playing safe and just keeping the ball on the table.
Right. Oh, look at the back, as if the backhand flick on return from Ma wasn't bad, but just completely smashed back by Fang Bo.
See the return there. I actually think, because they're so used to playing against each other, that actual return of serve, which is so effective against other players, isn't quite effective against Ma Long. He seems to be ready for it, and he gets a strong topspin in.
It was dismissed by the boss, 26-year-old Ma Long. Fang Bo, 3 years his junior. Oh, another incredible rally.
Interesting there, Fang Bo didn't back off, didn't want to take him on at topspin v topspin. He stayed up to the table, punching with the backhand block. Interesting tactics, very effective tactics. 4-3, Fang Bo in the lead.
It's a game of angles, luck of net cords, edge balls, odd deflections. The momentum can change in a heartbeat. Success and failure comes down often to a millimeter.
Took it early, Fang Bo. Chinese just seem to play it a tempo slightly above the rest of the world, taking it early, fast accelerating rackets. Ball travelling faster, hence they cause all sorts of problems when they play against the players from other parts of the world.
Went for the short receive, but just clipped the tape there, Fang.
I think he led 6-3 in the first game, 5-3 in this game, so he's certainly been thereabouts as Fang Bo.
Ma Long tying up at 5-all, second game. Greeted with a roar.
That's a very interesting shot from Fang Bo. Not sure if he meant that, because that flew up in the air far higher than normal, but it was fizzing with topspin, and you could see how relieved or pleased Ma Long was to win that point. He read the spin quite superbly.
Oh, fabulous redirection down the line off the backhand this time. from Ma Long.
And what this does, of course, it makes Fang Bo very nervous about going round the backhand and playing forehands, which is probably his strongest shot, because he's now thinking, if I step round my backhand to play forehands, Ma Long could go out wide to my forehand. And that's exactly what he was doing there. He was stepping round the backhand, hoping to get his forehand in from the backhand side. Very difficult to tell where a player's topspinning from, or two, I should say, because they can use their body to disguise the direction. But anyway, wins the next point.
Yeah, and Ma Long had won three in a row there, so Fang Bo just breaking the top seed's momentum. Tying up at 6-6 in the second game. Game to Ma Long in this race to 11 points, and indeed a race to four games as the winner's podium nears. I think that's what we're going to see. We're going to see roars every single point from now on in, because both men want this so much. Body language supreme from both. Intensity right up there as well. Just looking for any edge they can. Physically, technically, tactically, mentally.
That's the one he's been looking to get in, the forehand from the backhand side, but when he made contact then, you see it on the replay, ball's a little bit low. Of course, once the ball drops below table height, very difficult to get speed. You have to throw it a little bit up into the air to get it over the net.
Deadlock then, 7-7 second game. All to play for here. A gold medal awaits to the winner.
Both players edging round the backhand side of the table to play their forehands. That's where they're at their best, for sure. And it was Fang Bo who came out on top. Look how far they are, out wide on their backhand side.
They're just such good athletes. They just contort their bodies into elastic positions that mere mortals would just be down the physiotherapist after only one of these shots. Fang Bo then, with a one-point lead in the second game, 8-7. That was gutsy. The redirection down the line off the forehand to a capacity crowd out here in Suzhou. Chinese crowd very knowledgeable about their table tennis and very passionate too. Delighted with the contest unfolding in front of their eyes.
You can see there the desire for Fang Bo to get in with that forehand from his back, from the backhand side. Has to be a little bit careful, just leaving his, the forehand side of the table exposed.
Oh, sheer tenacity from the 13th seed, Fang Bo. He is desperate for the title.
He's taking the master on at topspin to topspin and beating him. Three game points for Fang Bo. He's played some tremendous points at the end of this second game. Full marks to him.
So Ma Long loses that game, 11-7, and his lead being pegged back by the 13th seed, Fang Bo. So we're a game apiece here in the men's singles final from Suzhou. Stay with us. Action from game three after the break. Which way is this men's singles final going to twist next? one game all in this best of seven encounter. Race to four. Fang Bo in the orange and blue is going to get us underway in game three, serving at the top of your picture.
Fang Bo playing some of the best table tennis I've ever seen him play in the final quarter of that second game. He took Ma Long on at topspin against topspin and came out on top. Particularly impressive with that forehand from the backhand side. But it's first point in this third game for Ma Long.
At this level, you can't take your foot off the pedal for a second. Oh, what a thunderous return from Ma Long's backhand. So explosive, so strong in the forearm. Just working the elbow and wrist axis so fast.
He kept the ball very low over the net. And if there's heavy topspin, the ball tends to stay, bounces and tends to stay low. Makes it very difficult to go down the line if the ball's net height or even below net height. Oh! That is a lesson in backhand and forehand topspins. Full marks to both players there. That was a great rally.
Take that and I raise you, says Ma Long.
The world's number one. Very impressive start. Leads 3-0, but it's been three great points. He's having to work for every single one. Bang ball there coming across to the forehand side to return with the backhand to get that wristy return in. I'm not sure that's quite as effective against Ma Long.
So Ma Long then wrestling the early advantage in this game three back in his favour, having lost the second game to the 13th seed.
The serve drifted long, second bounce over the baseline. See that again on the replay, there it is. He's able to wind up with the bat from underneath the table. You can't do that if the second bounce of the ball is over the table. Great start by Ma Long. Interesting, Paul, that Ma Long's referred to or has been appointed as the captain of the Chinese team here. He's clearly very well respected by all his teammates and the coaches. I guess in that role he's looking to inspire the rest of the team by example. He's certainly doing that.
Yes, he looks a daunting prospect right now, Ma Long. Serving 5-1 in the third game.
Close. Just not quite over the topspin with the racket angle.
I had one of those very quiet, pensive moments in the bus on the drive here, Don. It was a nice full moon that we were driving towards, thinking there might be a massive upset tonight.
Flat, 5-2. Certainly playing very well. Fang Bo.
You feel any let up from the top seed and he'll be in. So two terrific serves from Ma Long then. Extend his lead in this third game by 4 points. Ma leading 6-2. Fang with two serves to come. Has to keep the serve tight to the net. Low and short.
Good tight return from Ma Long. Soft hands, delicate touch return, as you see there. Fang Bo looking to flick the ball out wide, but it was just a fraction too low for him to do that. Again, it's the millimeters you were talking about, Paul, the difference between winning a point and losing a point. Oops. Mr. Low has foul served. Fang Bo. Has he? Yes, he has, and Fang Bo's asking why. He's asking the wrong person, actually. It's Mr. Low, who sat over the other side of the court. Ah, no. Point has been withdrawn. So the score now 7-2. The electronic scoreboard just a little bit slow on the court. But now everybody's in agreement. The score is 7-2. Fang Bo with his second serve. Not sure what happened with Mr. Lowe there, whether he withdrew his initial decision or simply there'd been an error. However, all is well. And Ma Long now with two serves to come, leading 7-3. Looking good for this third game, but still a bit of work to do.
Oh, ramping up the power again off the forehand side, Ma Long. Looking incredibly dynamic in his athleticism tonight. Just really alert, really wired and dialed in from the off, as he was in his semi-final against Fan Zhendong.
He's so good against that wristy backhand return, Ma Long. In with a very powerful forehand topspin. The return looked good to me, but Ma Long's so good against the speed and the spin generated by the wrist action. 9-3.
Yep, as we hit 9 o'clock local time, Ma Long extending his advantage in game three. Oh, he's found the edge ball, a very faint edge. Fang Bo, where did that come from, you lucky boy?
But there were some shots in that rally. Unfortunately, we're not seeing them all in the replay. We're just seeing the lobbing, and there's the edge ball. But there were some shots in that rally, and footwork and speed of movement that were just absolutely extraordinary.
Well, he's riding his luck, that's for sure, Fang Bo.
But arguably, the edge is not going to be influential. I can only see Ma Long winning this third game. It'd been better keeping that for 9-all.
Oh, magnificent. He's tightening the screw now, Ma Long. He's seemingly having majority of the answers out here.
But just watch this forehand topspin. Leaning back, but this guy has the ability to generate power when he's off balance. He's not in the right position. But he has such a fast arm action.
Six game points, Ma. And he's taken the first of those six for a 3-1 lead out here, 2-1 lead, I should say, in this men's singles final. Stay with us after the break. We'll bring action from game four.
We're being asked some very interesting questions, Paul. One coming in asking, why was Yan An not there? Countries are limited to 5 people. Why not the top 32 players plus invites? What an excellent point that is. Obviously, if it was the top 32 players, we'd probably have 16 Chinese here, which would, you know, potentially mean we'd have a lot more Chinese featuring in the latter rounds. Arguably, it's good to have a truly international flavour. So it's but an excellent question, and I'm one I'm sure the ITTF will be discussing.
Start of game four then, Ma Long serving from the top of the picture, leading 2-1 in this race to 4. Holds his finger up apologetically as he gets a faint edge.
Water! Another interesting question from Joe. He's asking about the mental advantage. Who has got the mental advantage in the final? And I do feel that has to be Ma Long here. I think if we'd have had Zhang Zhika in the final, I think Ma Long has an enormous amount of respect. I think we said this at the beginning for Zhang Zhika. He's the guy who performs on the big stage. Fang Bo, still an incredible player, not quite as achieved the world champion, Olympic champion status that Zhang Zhika did. So my answer to that is I think Ma Long here has the upper hand. He's leading 2-1 in games. He's leading 2-1 in points. But again, another very good question.
Hashtag ask the commentator for your Twitter and questions, and we'll answer them as best we can.
Gene asks us, what are the playing? What are the players shouting when they score? Sounds like Choi, goody, yo. I guess that's just a shout of
Gioi.
Fantastic. I think I would shout good boy, or I think it's just a shriek of delight that they've won the point.
Brilliant from Fang Bo. Crushed it down the line in the end to get it done. Really stayed on top of that point well, because Ma Long looking incredibly dynamic, closing down the spaces on the court well in defense. To no avail in the end. So it's a one-point game. Game four, Ma Long ahead 3-2. Fabulous redirection down the line there from Fang Bo. He saw that so quickly. Look how reflexive this was. Got it out in front, Don.
Yeah, but again, Ma Long had committed himself. A lot of people refer to that as running round blind. You're taking a chance. You're anticipating the ball coming on the diagonal, because that's what you'd expect the player to do. And that's why it's clever when a player goes down the line. It's brave. It's not what the opponent expects. So well done, Fang Bo.
Firing in all that quad leg power then, Fang Bo. In front for the first time in this game then, leading 4-3 now, the 13th seed. 23-year-old Fang Bo, world junior table tennis champion in 2009, took the clean sweep. That really is a feat. Singles, doubles and mixed.
Oh, great topspin. Interesting question just come in from Eddie. I think it's very relevant to what's happening down there. Do you think Fang Bo needs to play more technical to beat Ma Long? I think what Fang Bo has to do is try and take the initiative. It's the first player who's getting in with the strong topspin, holding the ground. If I was advising Fang Bo, he's just got to take a few high risks. When he plays his forehand from the backhand side, he can win points.
Court position tight to the table, try and take his time and space away. Both men bullying the ball at the moment as the drama unfolds in Suzhou. It's an intriguing, compelling watch in a full capacity house. 5,500 seats, not one free.
Ma Long now with his second serve in this sequence of two, 1 point adrift. Oh, that just flicked off the end, having hit the net. Fang Bo, a little bit unfortunate. There we see it. Only missed by millimetres. And that net cord just gave it a little bit of extra pace.
Both men giving their all, throwing the kitchen sink at each other at the moment, because you can tell that Fang Bo, in his mind, he doesn't want Ma Long accelerating away to a 3-1 lead in this race to four games. Needs to stay with the top seed to have a fighting chance here. Locked up at 5-all.
Great shot by Ma Long. Great question again. is it unfair that a good player doesn't get the chance just because of his nationality? And that's come in from
Koolsman.
Mr. Nemec. Great question, and absolutely. But I guess also, as well as having the best players, you need to have a spread of countries as well. It's having the, you know, as many of the 222 member countries taking part, as well as having the best players. A little bit of a compromise. Maybe the compromise is slightly wrong. We should have more of the better players, and maybe therefore less of the players from the lesser developed countries. Good questions, good points. So now, time out.
Twitter feed is just reeling with questions, Don. You're really earning a keep tonight.
Lots of questions coming in. Yeah. Apologies, we can't answer them all. So, 1 minute break is now up. And both players now coming back to the table. Marlon just taking his time. Of course, if he can win this game 3-1, would mean that Fang Bo has to win three consecutive games against the number one in the world. That's tough, Paul, with the best will in the world. Mm. So this is a critical part of this match, particularly for Fang Bo.
Fang Bo serving, then trailing 5-6 in this vital fourth game. Oh, the statement of intent again from Ma Long as he marches to pick up the ball. He's a man on a mission tonight. I, for one, wouldn't want to be stood in his way, Don.
It's an incredible amount of power he generates. But when you look at the action, it's just total body action. Completely uses the whole body, drives with his legs, twists with the upper body, throws the whole arm into it, the shoulder, the elbow, the wrist. He's now got a two-point lead with two serves to come. I think Fang Bo needs one of these 2 points at least. It's the first one to Marlon. Got him well behind the serve. The return was slightly weak, and you just can't afford to do that against Marlon.
Timeout very much favouring Marlon then. He's excelled since resuming. 2 points away from a 3-1 lead.
Again, Marlon forcing Fang Bo away from the table. There's not many players can take on Marlon when he's close to the table, as you see on the replay, and his opponent's away from the table. There's Fang Bo going away from the table against one of the most powerful players in the world, Paul. Recipe
really
for defeat.
Really imposing his character now on the young 23-year-old Fang Bo. Oh, that's a big forehand, though, to reduce the deficit to 3 points rather than four for Fang.
Fang takes the first point with a serve. He has to take the second, I feel. He can't afford to go 10-6 down with Marlon's two serves to come.
Brilliant forehand flick over the table. Fang Bo reduces the lead that Marlon has to 2 points now. That's achievable.
And so Marlon calls the timeout. He realizes that this is a pivotal moment in this whole match. If he can win this game 3-1 up, a really strong position. He's got his two serves to come, so he can think a bit about how he's going to serve, where he's going to serve to, and then he'll look to construct a point where he dominates from close to the table, gets in with the first spin.
Yeah, that was a timely break of Fang Bo's momentum, he hopes. Fang Bo having won the last 2 points, served very well in doing so as well, and backing up well with thunderous shots. But is that man with his back to us going to keep sustaining the momentum? Marlon hopes not. That's why he's called this minute timeout, to regroup and hopefully stop the rot.
quick question from one of the viewers. While the players are coming back, did you notice that when they use smashes, they are smashing with the backhand rubber? That varies from player to player. It all depends on how the rubber's playing. Some players like a fast rubber on one side, a slower, spinnier rubber on the other. And then for the odd shot, when they've got time, sometimes it's more suitable to use the other side of the racket. So that's all down to the player. It's all down to the rubber that they're actually playing with and the characteristics of the rubber. Of course, some players will use short pimples, long pimples. 9-7. Three game points for the world's number one player.
And you feel a 3-1 lead, I think most people in this auditorium would agree, would be pretty much unassailable for Fang Bo in their quest for the gold medal. Oh, great soft hands from Fang Bo with the short game. Really nicely administered around the net. And then just the change of acceleration, really upping the ante, particularly from the forehand side here. Got around it well. Keeping the pressure on Ma Long. Finishes with a faint edge.
Ma Long is quite in order using the towel. It's every 6 points, as you explained earlier, Paul. But now he's back at the table. And he needs 1 point. But Fang Bo with his two serves. He has to take these two, I feel.
Oh, he's made it. Ma Long with a lucky net cord then after a great dig off his forehand side. Does indeed extend his lead to 3-1 in this men's singles final. Stay with us after the break.
Just while we wait for the players to start, another quick question from Ronnie. And he's asking about the Indian players and what's the standard of the Indian players and are they lagging behind? Play very well here, the Indian players. Yes, they're not right at the top, but they're some very exciting players. Ashanta actually had to give a walkover to the gentleman who's about to serve. Fang Bo, he had a leg injury, he beat Simon Gorsi, but the play recommences. And it's Ma Long who's in with a great topspin against the serve. Topspin. Another interesting question about the timeouts. Why have they both used the timeouts so early? Well, very simply, Paul, that fourth game is crucial. 3-1 now puts Ma Long very much in the driving seat. I wouldn't say an unassailable position, but it's going to be very difficult for Fang Bo. They both knew that. They both really needed to win that fourth game. And they were prepared to throw their timeouts at it.
Oh, what a forehand return. Threw caution to the wind, unleashed the fury to reduce the deficit to just one. It is a must-win game for the young Fang Bo. Oh, he is so pumped, so highly charged and intense.
I think we'll just take one more question and then we'll focus on this game. Good question about the spectators being a little bit too far from the playing area. It's interesting, as they've gone down from 8 tables to 4 to 2 to 1, they haven't brought the sides in. I think the spectators who are sat behind either end of the table are in a great position, but the people at the sides are actually a little bit further away from the table than would normally be the case. So very good point. I don't like to be critical, but it's been absolutely superb here in Suzhou. But yes, at the sides, maybe a fraction closer would be better.
Yeah, we've had 977 matches in all in this table tennis competition. And the media committee, organising committee, have excelled themselves.
So if we can focus now on the match and not too many more questions, but the questions have been great and many thanks for asking them. We're just about to see some history. Ma Long on his way to his first world title. He's leading 3-1, he's 4-2 up, he's playing quite majestically at the moment, with finesse, with power. And those two things are very difficult to combine, the touch and then the rockets. And you can tell by the shout that he's getting excited.
He will not be denied, you feel, Ma Long, at this stage. He's roaring like a lion down there, every single point. It's the title he so desperately wants. His compatriot Zhang Jike has 2 world championship titles. He wants this one.
Oh, listen to him. He knows it's he knows it's on its way. He has a little bit more work to do. In fact, he's got to win 5 more points. But he's well on his way here. He's just got to keep the momentum going. So Fang Bo beats the world's number 3. He beats the world's number 2. It looks like the world's number 1 is just one step too far, but full marks to the 23-year-old. What a tournament he's had. We're going to see a lot more of him. Indeed, he could still come back. Let's not get too carried away. And with a service like that.
Fast, long rocket down the line, forehand side, completely flummoxing Ma Long. That'll throw a spanner in the works.
Not many people can do that. It wasn't quite an ace when we see the replay. Just look at that. He just gets the edge of his bat. It pings off the edge of his bat.
Even Ma Long, with all of his years of experience, couldn't see that one coming. Just a very dexterous flick of the wrist, such disguise. Oh, that's 2 in a row for Fang Bo. On the comeback trail.
So the only question mark now is Ma Long just keeping his nerve. A little bit of pressure now. 6-2, 6-4. No timeouts left, so play will be continuous until the end of this final.
Has to guard against complacency, has to keep the intensity up. The tempo strong.
Flat, 6-4.
Mr. Lowe just calling. Let service, well spotted. Very ambitious from Fang Bo. Yes, you've got to be positive, but clearly there is a line where maybe that was too high a risk, but it's such a difficult line to find when you're playing somebody like Ma Long. Maybe on that occasion it just crossed that line. Just trying to hit it a little bit too hard. 7-4. The counter topspin from Ma Long. Didn't quite get over the ball sufficiently. I think it may have gone off the side, actually. We'll see here on the replay. No, it's off the end of the table, so absolutely correct that he didn't get his racket over the top enough. Again, both players using the towel. A further 6 points have progressed. And it's Fang. Should he take 2 points with the service, which is possible, then we would be all square. So this 5th game, far from over. What an angle he got there. Slowed it down a little bit. There wasn't quite the speed and spin, but it was wide to Fang Bo's backhand. Fang will be disappointed with that one, particularly off his serve. He's got some great serves. maybe he could look to get in behind them a fraction more. But again, it's that balance between making sure he gets the ball on and being positive. That's exactly what he did there. That was an excellent forehand topspin from the backhand side of the table with his forehand. So the lead still at 2 points, and it's now Ma Long with his two serves to come.
3 points from a gold medal. Would that inhibit you? Let's find out. Oh, sheer brilliance on the fight back from Fang Bo. Where did that one come from?
You'll see here, he actually does a pirouette. Oh, you can't see it, it's just off screen to the right. He actually spins round.
Yes.
Such is the amount of body action he put into that forehand topspin.
You could see him on the recoil, just trying to recover back into the court in case Ma Long had retrieved it, but he hit it lights out. It's been a compelling watch, this. Every single point, you cannot take your eyes off it for a moment. Oh, it's lights out table tennis here in Suzhou. Remarkable, extraordinary rally from both men.
That is as good as it gets, topspin versus topspin. Just look at the body action. Incredible power. Just look at the jubilation there. That's the best point of this final. Arguably one of the best points of the tournament. Perhaps the rally wasn't quite as long, but the quality of play was amazing.
Thunderous hitting from both. Ma Long inching towards the title. Just 2 points away then. Fangbo trailing 7-9 in this vital must-win game for him. Oh, fabulous.
Ma Long, of course, has the two serves at the end of this game. Service a distinct advantage in table tennis, particularly in singles. Eight, nine. Well done, Fang Bo. 9 points each.
A roar in the auditorium as they all appreciate just how much Fang Bo's putting into this. Both men giving their all in a tremendous contest. Look at that evasive action for Ma Long there.
So now, Ma Long with two serves.
Nip and tuck the whole way in this men's singles final.
He'll be looking to get in behind the serve. I suspect a short serve, but then again, I don't think like a world champion, he might go for a variation, the long fast serve. I suspect short, and I suspect he'll try and get in behind the serve. Great return by Fang Bo. Read the spin well, touched it back over the net.
Deep breathing skills for Ma Long. These are big, big moments as Fang Bo has generated his own game point. Can he take us into a sixth game?
Backhand to backhand.
Deuce, we go.
Fang Bo just getting his racket over the top a little bit too much, so it's now alternate serving.
Two clear points to win the game.
Fang Bo with the first serve.
Such a buzzy, electric atmosphere in the auditorium now. Everybody fully engaged, enjoying this drama unfolding. In this men's singles final in the World Championships.
Oh, what a return and serve. Number one, he says. He came across, returned it with a backhand, not something he does a lot of. But here he goes, and he goes out wide.
Fangbo committed himself to the forehand from the backhand side. He took a gamble. He ran round blind, as we referred to earlier. And now, world championship point for Ma Long. And he's serving.
Real courage from Fang Bo there.
Ma Long gets in behind the serve. That's what he wanted to do, but look at the counter topspin.
Nerves of steel from the younger player. Fang Bo acquitting himself magnificently on this world stage. 11 all. Lockdown.
Believe that.
Outrageous table tennis from both.
The crowd,
point of the championship right
the crowd
there.
Are on their feet. I thought we had the best point of the day earlier. That has to be the best point.
That
I don't know
amazing.
How many shots that was. What a point that would have been to win the championship win. It gives game point to Fang Bo. Both players taking their time, I'm sure, to get their breath back.
That was an absolute lung buster. Wow. Definitely makes the highlight reel. Point of the championships.
So,
Fang Bo coming out on top.
Absolutely. And Ma Long now serving to stay in this fifth game. He's done it.
Roar of delight. Fang Bo has sealed the fifth game, 13 points to 11. And we are going to be treated to game six. Do stay with us after the break.
And the players now coming back to the table for the sixth game. Just a quick question. Do you think the towel breaks are a little bit too long for TV? Well, I'm delighted to say the ITTF introduced a rule to stop the players using the towel all the time, and it's every 6 points. So it's certainly a lot better than it used to be. Good question from Matt. And now let's stay with the action. Ma Long will serve. He leads by 3-2. That has to be one of the best individual games of table tennis I've ever seen. Two of the most remarkable rallies that I've ever seen, but the one at the end of that game was just absolutely incredible.
And this has to be the most followed table tennis event ever, as Ma Long gets us underway then. Start of game six, leading 3-2 in games.
And you just wonder now whether Ma Long, of course, beginning to feel the pressure. Of course, the one accusation against what has been a wonderful career is the Pro Tour Master. He wins all the tournaments on the world circuit. Incredible record.
15 titles.
He's not won the Olympics and he's not won the Worlds.
Well, he would be inhuman, Don, if he wouldn't feel the pressure, because Fang Bo is just bringing lights out table tennis. It's just absolute table tennis genius right now from him.
So poor old Ma Lum, Long, very much up against it mentally here. Credit to Fang Bo. It's just
momentum's clearly with him now, Fang Bo, isn't it? The first 2 points there, the last few points of that.
Can he ride this wave all the way to a vital seventh?
Good return of serve by Ma Long.
He saw the stamp of the feet from Fang Bo. He knows how critical that was to stay on the top seed and not let him come up for air. A bit like a float in a swimming pool once you've got it under your foot. Don't let it bob back up to the surface. It's all about sustaining momentum. Runs of two, runs of 3 points, however you can.
Good return of serve from Ma Long. Put the ball at the top of the bounce, elbow wrist, threw the ball, a little bit of side spin on it. Went through very flat. And so the score's level, 2 points each. Ma Long looking to reassert himself. That was a very well placed topspin deep into the backhand of Fang Bo.
And it was high percentage too. He had a lot of work on that ball just to ensure it. A lot of rainbow shape to it as well, and a heavy hit. So Ma Long breaking the momentum that Fang Bo had at the back of game four, game five, I should say. It's nip and tuck the whole way, this men's singles final. It's been incredible. Table tennis from the top draw.
3 points each, 3-2 for Ma Long. This sixth game, evenly poised. Yeah, it was a great backhand. Fang Bo doing his best to lean and get in with the forehand topspin, contorting himself. Just look how he has to move his body sideways. He's falling backwards, lost his balance, yes, and then lost control.
As great as his dynamic balance is, just spilling long of the table off the forehand there. So Ma Long, a point in the ascendancy in this sixth game. Oh, brilliant. He found the line. Fang Bo left the gate open and he threaded the needle.
The interesting thing here, Paul, and you'll appreciate the subtleties of this, in the previous game when Ma Long was 6-2 up, he was going absolutely crazy as though, but now a lot calmer, just keeping his composure, taking each point as it comes, just preparing himself, just wiping the table there.
Both men very ritualistic, as you expect in these moments of pressure. It's their go-to strategies to just calm themselves down, their rituals. Oh, it was excellent short touch from Fang Bo, but Ma Long onto it at whirlwind speed, getting it right at the apex of the bounce. Watch this. There he goes, and a big forehand flick across the table. Extending his lead then by 3 points here in this must-win game for Fang Bo.
Good question coming in from Murrayfield Table Tennis Club about the yellow card that Ma Long got after the big point. I did see the yellow card, but I'm not sure what it was for, so good question. Apologies, I don't know the answer to that one. What a point, what touch from Ma Long.
Second bounce would have bounced right on the white line, wouldn't it? It was perfect. Look, watch this. Fang Bo just tied up.
But how did he keep it so low over the net? Just wonderful touch. If that had popped up another inch, then Fang Bo would have been in. That return, the touch was perfect.
Ramping up the pressure then, the man in black, the world number one. He's regrouped very well after the loss of the fifth game. 4 points ahead now, Ma Long. Fang Bo trailing 3-7. And he served a fault.
Again, Ma Long just a little bit of a cry of I'm getting but much more composed, not getting as excited as he did in game number five. Game number six, we're seeing a much more composed world number one player, 3 points away from the title that he so much wants. Let's serve called. So the deficit remains at 5 points, 8-3 in favour of Ma Long. Unbeaten so far in this year. It looks like that's going to remain the case. 9-3, surely. Fang Bo can't come back from 9-3, Paul.
Sheer will and determination written all over the face of the top seed now. He's done remarkably well because the resistance that Fang Bo put up at the tail end of that fifth game was just phenomenal and really quite off-putting in the face of Ma Long. So Ma Long staring down the barrel and coming out smelling of roses so far, just 2 points away from a gold medal. Brilliance from Ma Long. He's rousing the crowd as well. He's really enjoying the moment.
7 match points. He's dreamt of this situation for the last 5-6 years, if not all his life, but certainly during his professional career.
Look at that, orchestrating the crowd wonderfully, really captivating the moment.
Bring it on, he's saying. 10-3, here he goes. Will he do it at the first time of asking? Not quite, that just missed, only by a very narrow margin.
He wanted to go out in flames of glory. Still got 6 more championship points to play with, but 2 of them on the Fang Bo serve.
So 2 Fang Bo serves. Surely Fang Bo can't come back again. No, he can't.
There it is, the roar from Ma Long. Look at this, scenes of celebration. Unbelievable match. Got across the line after a testing evening, demonstrating mental fortitude to keep the talented Fang Bo at bay. So it's Ma Long who comes of age, finally silences his critics and announces himself as a legend on the world stage. He lays his ghost to rest as the Juros 2015 World Table Tennis Champion.
It's always great to see the best player win. He's deserved to win. So my congratulations to what is at the moment the best player in the world. He deserved it. And he's still got the energy to jump up on that table. Well done. And the interviews are taking place now. Poor Fang Bo. He's been interviewed immediately after his defeat, but one of our co-commentators there, Paul, Dong Wang, in action.
Fang Bo is saying that actually in the sixth game, actually, that certainly it shows that he is lacking experience and also the way to deal with difficulties, and he feels sorry about it. 其实你的名字方博已经是印刻在很多人的可以说是心中。这次大赛中你一路上过关斩将，最终杀入了男单的决赛，应该还得是对这次的比赛，还是整个的过程，还是感到满意的吧？
比较遗憾吧，但是能够在这种大赛上能尽情的去展现自己、表现自己的，我觉得这是一个很好的平台吧。所以说，没关系嘛，那个以后还有机会。一点不错，还有机会，我们再次把掌声送给方博。
He's saying that he actually is not going to give up. It's a shame that he lost here, but he is going to actually train even harder to do even better down the line. 好，到了我们的冠军马龙这边。马龙其实刚才方博也讲了，在比赛中他救下过一个冠军点，当时的心情怎么样？给我们形容一下，怎么在第六局中又重新再次的出发，再次的重整旗鼓。
应该来说，其实第五局自己还是有挺大的机会能够去取胜嘛。然后可能自己在那一个冠军点的时候，自己这种其实是一个半机会球，可能还是。
多少有一些侥幸，然后拉到方博的正手位，让他反拉一个，然后遗憾的输掉第五局。其实这种当时脑子里也突然也想到萨格勒布马林跟大力的那场球。其实但自己第六局，我觉得开局也不是很好，0-2落后，但还是依然能够去坚定自己。我除了弃权，就只能坚持，所以说最后还是坚持下来了。
Marlon was sharing with us actually saying that he saved one championship point afterwards. He really was trying to regroup himself. A lot of memories were there. On the other hand, he thought that he had to tough it out. He was glad that he actually did so. So, 再问一个问题哈, Marlon, 今天比赛之前很多人讲你是没有退路可言的，这是一场必须胜出的比赛，是不是顶着了巨大的压力在今天比赛中展现出自己的能量了？
其实我觉得这一次比赛，作为我来说都有一些压力吧，因为毕竟自己之前的这种连续三届半决赛都输了，然后这次又是在中国打，然后看到现场这么多球迷，包括大家对我这种期待嘛，自己也是比较想证明自己，所以说，最近这一段自己每天我感觉都是背负着压力，但我觉得最好一点就是今天。 无论是半决赛还是决赛，自己在面对这种压力的时候，依然能够去打出自己的水平吗？
Marlon was saying he was very happy to deal with this kind of pressure in the men's semifinals and also final. Yes, indeed, a lot of people were expecting him to do well. He was happy to do so on home soil before the home crowd. We're very proud of you. 我们确实为你骄傲。再问最后一个问题啊，其实很多人很喜欢你的发饰啊，你的发饰也给大家这个焕然一新的感觉，又拿了一个可以说分量很重的世界冠军。那么我们希望你把这个发饰继续留下去，你看怎么样啊？
好的，只要大家喜欢，我就继续坚持。大家喜欢吗？All right,
继续留下去吧。 Ladies and gentlemen, the eventual champion of the men's singles, Marlon of China. 我们再次把掌声送给2015年的男单世界冠军马龙。
English Table Tennis Association has rebranded. It's now Table Tennis England. A subtle point, but an important one.
Fan Zhendong then. The fourth seed in this event, just taking to the stage. He lost 4-2 to Ma Long in the semi-finals earlier today. He had the privilege of commentating on that match. What a player for the future, the teenage sensation is very much a part of the top Chinese pack. Wonderful player, nicknamed Little Chubby. 5'8", bronze medalist here then. Former 2012 World Junior Table Tennis Champion. Here's Zhang Jike, the man who's twice World Champion, 2011 and 2013, Rotterdam and Paris respectively. Just losing out in the semi-finals on this occasion to a wonderful performance from his compatriot Fang Bo, the 13th seed. So Zhang goes home. With a bronze medal as well as Fan. Fang Bo, what a tournament he's had, this young man. Incredible. Winner of the World Junior Championships in 2009. Took the clean sweep on that occasion, singles, doubles, and mixed. Didn't he put up a sterling resistance against Ma Long in the final? 4-2 in the end to Ma Long, but this man, definitely a player for the future. Such potential he has. Had an opportunity to become a hero today, but he did so in his own right. Didn't quite come of age, but what a performance he put on for us.
And the World Table Tennis Champion, Peoples Republic of China.
金牌获得者，世界乒乓球锦标赛冠军。
So silver to Fang Bo. And gold to the man with his arms aloft in the light blue tracksuit, Ma Long.
It's always good when the best player in the tournament wins the singles. I think he's deserved it. He's played well all season. He's unbeaten in 2015. He kept that record going here. Thomas Vicard, president of the International Table Tennis Association, or Federation, I should say, presents the medal and the flowers. And then Sandra Deaton, the chairman of Table Tennis England, will move into action and present the St. Bride's vase. Sandra's daughter Nicola, stalwart of the England table tennis team. A very proud moment for Sandra. the St. Bride's Vase, named after a table tennis club in London just off Fleet Street, where Fred Perry learned to play, and was donated by the club to the ITTF in 1927, I think, the year that Fred Perry won the World Championship. So a lot of history behind this trophy. Fred Perry, of course, won Wimbledon as well as the World Table Tennis Championships. I don't think we'll see that happen again, Paul. And so now the national anthem of China once again.
After 8 days of punishing competition, then a rapturous ovation deserved by the medalists, Ma Long on the gold podium, who really has come of age finally on this world championship stage. He silenced his critics and announces himself as a legend on the world platform. He's laid his ghost to rest this week as the Quaros 2015 world champion. So this really is the official declaration then of the closing ceremony, if you like. They are all smiles for Ma Long. He says, "It's mine, give it back to Fang Bo." He got so close. But Ma Long, very much the champion this year. The 2015 Quaros World Table Tennis Champion, Ma Long, just takes in the applause and savours the moment. It's been a long time coming, but he really has acquitted himself remarkably this week under a lot of pressure from